Hello, beautiful singers. This is Valerie White Williams and Vocal Splendor Studios. And today I want to talk to you about the vocal cords, what every singer needs to know. Now, the vocal cords is where the sound comes from, where the sound is vibrating. If you think about the vocal cords, think of them like a guitar string. When we pluck the string, it vibrates and it makes sound. And that's what our vocal cords do. We make, instead of plucking the string, we are using our breath to flow through the vocal cords and making that sound vibration. Now, let me tell you, the terminology that the vocal scientists and pedagogues prefer to use these days are vocal cords. So if you want to make a great impression on people, you say, oh, it's not vocal cords, it's vocal folds. Now, the reason why they like that term is that actually that's what the vocal cords look like. They look like some origami that's been turned over on the edges, and we have this nice piece of paper with some folds on the edges. Now, the action of the vocal cords is this. I'm going to use my fingers to demonstrate the vocal cords. In fact, I should say the vocal cords are behind the larynx right here, and they sit behind the larynx, kind of sitting parallel to the ground, and they open and close like this. Open and close. Now, every time we take a breath, they separate, and every time we speak or sing, they come together, and the breath flows through them, and we get sound. And there's a little bit more to it. We actually resonate against what we call the vocal tract, which is the back of the throat and the mouth. And that's the resonator, because we had a guitar string. Without a guitar, we wouldn't hear the sound. The guitar body creates the resonating chamber. So our resonating chamber is our mouth and the back of our throat. So that's kind of the mechanics of the voice. We got the breathing, the pump through the vocal cords, resonating in the mouth chamber. So let's go back to the vocal folds, what you need to know about the vocal folds. First off is, like I said, they open and close. So that's where the breathing comes in, because when the cords come together and assume the right position, we want them to come together gently and strong, not banging and not really weak and anemic. So the breath helps bring the cords together in a more functional manner, a more consistent manner. So that's number one. Second thing is the vocal cords are really pieces of elastic and gristle that are controlled by muscle. So the muscles are really the two muscle groups that control the vocal cords. The first one is the muscle that brings the cords together, that brings them into this strong onset, and that is the thyroarytenoid muscle. We call it TA muscle for short. And that's the muscle that brings the cords together. We're going to use more of that action on the low notes when we're in our what we call the chest voice. And it's really because we're using mostly that thick, full onset with the vocal cords. And the second muscle group that controls the vocal cords is the cricothyroid muscles. And what they do is they lengthen the vocal cords into longer positions that we use for our high notes. So when we think of opera music or singing in our head voice, we're going to use predominantly the cricothyroid production, although we use both aspects of the vocal cords, the cords that bring them together and the cords that lengthen them. So it's a pretty sophisticated process in our vocal cords. Some vocal pedagogues consider the vocal cords like a CD on a hard drive, that the hard drive is where all the action is happening, but the breath energy is the power source. And then our face and our head is like the monitor. So the vocal cords are controlled by our brain. We do not have to micromanage those muscles. We don't have to think, oh my gosh, I'm singing high B. I really need to use my cricothyroid muscles. We just think high B and the cords assume the correct position. So what the cords need is, first off, an understanding of how the breathing works. Secondly, understanding that our brain controls the pitch. So we don't have to direct the pitch by our head or other tricks that singers do, or lift our head for the high notes. The high notes are in here. And so trusting the breath and trusting our brain to find the right notes there. And then the other thing that our vocal cords need is a sense of relaxation. If you notice, I can move my larynx around like this. I can also make the larynx go high by doing this and lifting up and down. And so I have found that when the larynx is nice and smooth and loose, things function easier. And if you watch the really good singers, you will see a sense of relaxation through the face and jaw and the neck. And the reason why they can do that, because they are hooked up to that really great breath. And the breath is the foundation so everything can flow. The larynx is like a pampered princess. We need to give it what it needs. We need to not let it stress out. It's like the princess and the pea. It needs all this relaxation to function in its ideal state. So we need to take care of our larynx. And that is the lesson of the larynx. And if you want to look online, you can certainly do a lot of video searching on vocal cords, vocal folds. I encourage you to do that so you can see the action of the larynx in real time. And I'll be honest, it's not a pretty picture. They're not really pretty, but you get to see how they operate, how the cords come together, and how they function and how they vibrate. The main thing is the things I told you. Use your breath, stay relaxed, understand your brain controls it, and that's about, you're good to go. All right, this is Valerie Williams in Vocal Splendor Studios, and we'll talk to you next time. Bye.